It's rock and roll.
Go on, Wayne.
Like Tom Jones?
Yeah, great.
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone.
I'm attracted to old buildings, the character, and of course the cheap rent helps a wee bit. And you know, I really dig, well, 90% of the time, wandering in at the crack of dawn, you know. We open about 10 and, you know, having a cup of tea and having people in. And well, I mean, what other job in the world can you get where you can say, hey, have a cup of tea, sit down, we'll talk about guitars and talk shit, you know? Yeah. It's great.
Sounds ideal.
Yeah.
So how many years have you been doing this now?
For myself, in conjunction with the studio, I suppose I've been doing my own thing about 20 odd years, really.
Okay, so we've got like this is a great teenage boy's wet dream, this wall of guitars here.
Well, what? Actually, Paul, I'm going to freak you out a bit here, and the demographic that comes into the shop is between 35 and 60.
Is that right?
Yeah. The teenage thing is not that big. Not in my shop, anyway. I mean, maybe they're going to the bigger, more corporatized...
The better ones, the better shops.
Yeah, the bigger and the better shops. You know, the shinier and lots more. I mean, you can get rows and rows of good guitars elsewhere.
Yeah, but not second-hand guitars.
No, that's true. That's true. Ones with character.
What about this guy down here?
I wouldn't trust that bastard.
Now, I've always been fascinated by these like Siamese twin guitars, but I'm sure they've got a better name than that.
Twin neck.
Twin neck.
It's very complex. Yeah.
How do you say that? Twin neck.
Twin neck, man. You know, with a slight emphasis on the Geordie.
So who would play that?
Jimmy Page, you know, in that really wonderful movie. Song remains the same. They've got a new thing coming out as well. So Jimmy Page made it really famous, you know. Comes in waves, you know. For a while there was a lot of retro Japanese things, you know, selling really well. Funky, early 70s Japanese. And to a high degree, it was a lot of southern bands, not Leonard Skinner type, but you know, Dunedin-y.
Oh, yeah, southern New Zealand bands.
Yeah, yeah. They were playing a lot of that type of thing, you know, that lovely jangly sound and that. Still a Strat and Les Pauls and Rickenbackers, they're the thing.
So they're always popular?
Always. You know, everybody always wanted to own a Strat. It's the new status symbol, owning a Strat and a Fender Twin or a Fender Amp.
Now, do you get people coming in here to try out a guitar, and do they always play Stairway to Heaven?
Well, I encourage them to. It's my favourite song.
You haven't heard it played on a guitar ever, have you? I bet.
Well, it used to be.
It used to be, but not anymore.
You know, and there used to be all of them jokes that went around in the 70s and 80s, you know, if you play with Stairway to Heaven, we'll throw you out and stuff like that. But, you know, I'd kind of dig it if somebody came and played it now. Thank you.
Can we hear you doing a little doodling? So you can play. So that's your steel string acoustic. And
yeah.
So give us the sound of the nylon string
nylon,
now.
A bit sweeter. Yeah, that's it. This is just a cheapie.
It's puzzling. I don't think I've ever seen anything quite like this before.
Done.